Good evening and welcome to the Bahamas Tonight, the National Report. I'm Keishla Adderley. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. Topping the news, a judicial review filed on behalf of shantytown residents asserts that applicants have the full protection of the law to which every person in the Bahamas is entitled. That's part of the basis of their case they're preparing to go to the Supreme Court with as they seek to stop eviction and demolitions, which were set for this Friday, August 10th. An injunction was filed Friday, putting any government action pertaining to shanty towns here in New Providence on hold. Tonight we have details of why the largely Haitian ethnic group believes they should have a right to lay claim to the land they've settled on for years.
The affidavit of Stephanie St. Fleur, the president of Rights Bahamas, notes that unregulated communities have emerged in New Providence in the last four decades, and the government presumes that it is Crown land to which the Crown is absolutely entitled, though admitting that grants and leases have been made in respect to the land. She submits that a large group of residents believe these leases or grants still exist, and therefore they have a right to occupy the land. The affidavit further notes that the eradication policy appears to be explained by the government as an attempt to command decades after the fact that everyone comply with rules regarding building permits, and suggests that that is not the objective at all. She reasons that the land which constitutes shanty towns was mainly in rural areas which were out of sight and out of mind and were known to exist and were tolerated. She says as urban centers approached, these unregulated communities were completely eradicated in the most brutal way to make way for urban developments for Bahamians. St. Fleur also refers to legal arguments suggesting that some land is leased with the permission of tenants. She also contends that some occupants were trespassers against the Crown who have acquired title by adverse possession. St. Fleur also speaks to the issue of citizenship and or residency, contending that the large Haitian ethnic group living in shanty towns are either Bahamian citizens, permanent residents, work permit holders, annual residents, and or persons to be registered as citizens of the Bahamas, whom she referred to as citizens in waiting. The applicants also challenged the lawfulness of the government's planned eviction and demolition, concluding that the notices to leave the land did not seek possession of the land, but merely instructed recipients to demolish the buildings. St. Fleur put forth the view that these notices were being used as a means to claim possession of the land without establishing any right to do so. She also expresses concern that as the August 10th deadline approaches, shantytown communities would be subject to aggressive joint operations by law enforcement, which would demoralize and terrorize them. Keishla Adderley, ZNS Network News.